Hello, 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 and welcome to the Cleaning Learning Academy. I'm so glad you decided to join us. And if you find this channel helpful, please make sure you subscribe. Today, we're going to talk about how to stop chasing cleaning contracts. One of the problems is in the cleaning industry, there doesn't seem to be a sense of urgency. So let's say you have someone that really seems like they're interested, and you give them a call, you tell them they say that they want to bid, and the next thing you know, you call them again and again and again. They've taken the bid, but now all of a sudden they're not returning your call and they do not seem interested in your bid at all. What do you do? So these are the questions that we get a lot, and our goal on this channel is to make sure we help you start or grow your cleaning business as much as possible. Now, we really specialize in government contracts, but we also answer questions throughout on any subject on cleaning. So today's subject was how to stop chasing cleaning contracts. And the main way you do that is to make sure that you add value to whomever account you're trying to actually obtain. So if you're trying to obtain someone's account, one of the things you want to make sure you do is you let them know that you are going to add value to their company. So the first thing you need to do is understand what your business is going to do differently than any other cleaning business that is in your area. And the way you do that is you should sum up your competition. You should actually get on the websites. You should see exactly what they're offering that is going to be different from what you're offering. Now, the reason why everyone can offer something different is because each company has a different owner and no one is alike. So you're bringing your own personality, you're bringing your own style, you're bringing your own experience. That is what's going to set you apart from any other cleaning company and any other cleaning company owner. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that you write down at least five or six things that you bring to your company that's uniquely you. It could be your background in the military, where you had to clean and take care of the barracks. It could be that you grew up in a large family where you had to make sure everything was organized. Part of cleaning is making sure that the cleaning business is organized. You have to make sure you have payroll organized, the equipment, the supplies. This is something that you're bringing that maybe someone grew up with only one sibling isn't bringing the same experience that you're bringing when it comes to a large family. The other thing you can look at is any type of business acumen you've had in the past. Were you a Boy Scout? Did you used to sell cookies? Were you a Girl Scout? Did you have a small paper route? Well, you had different experience when it came to your first job. What you're going to do is you're going to make sure you bottle all that up, and you're going to be able to make sure you translate that to the new customer that you're trying to obtain their account. The way you're going to do that is you're going to make sure that they understand that you're going to clean for value, that you're going to add to their bottom line by making sure that, one, you understand what their needs are. You're going to listen when you go in for the walkthrough. What are their needs? Take accurate notes, because it's not what you want to bring, it's what they need. So when you're listening to all the problems and concerns that they've had before, either by not having a company there before or the company that was there not doing what they need to do, this is where you're going to step in and solve their problem. When you solve their problem, whether it be making sure that the facilities are very well stocked, cleaned well, making sure the hot spots like door handles, door, and as far as like the light switches, door handles, phones, things like that are going to be sanitized. You're going to make sure that you take care of the other hotspots, which are ladies' restrooms. That's just one area. Men, not as much, but ladies' restrooms, you will lose an account if you have ladies that are not happy with the way the restrooms are being taken care of. Conference rooms, because that's where most companies bring in their guests, anyone that's coming in for a meeting. So they want to make sure that everything is up to par. but there are hot spots inside of every building that you clean. So one hot spot could be the lobby, the receptionist area. That's where a lot of visitors come, the restrooms, the conference rooms, the CEO's desk, the financial chief officer's desk. These are the areas, and these are the things that you're going to make sure that you're going to handle that's going to stand out from any other company. When you bring that, you had better believe that if you present that during your bid, you're not going to have to chase them down. The other thing is, it depends on how they were referred to you. If they were referred through Google, if they were referred through a friend, all of this will also matter on the sense of urgency they feel in getting back with you. So when you present what you're going to add as a cleaning company to the bottom line, you will stop having to chase. So just remember, the number one thing is adding value to the customer, presenting it in a way that they understand that you're going to solve their problems, listening to what the problems are before you start presenting solutions, and then being able to accurately and consistently solve the problems on a day-to-day, week-to-week, and month-to-month. It's not just getting the accounts, it's maintaining them that matters as well. So if you're interested in a webinar that we have on how to obtain government contracts, and in addition to that, how to stop chasing contracts, cleaning contracts, then make sure you click on the link below, where we're going to have a step-by-step and just more detail of what we just went over on what you need to make sure you let them know that you are ready to add value to their company and help them solve their problems. So if you're interested, make sure that you subscribe to this channel so you can get all our latest. Whenever we have a new video, you'll receive a notification. So you have to subscribe to have that happen. And also, if you're interested in our webinars on getting government contracts, and if you're interested in how to stop chasing cleaning contracts, make sure you click the link and you'll be sent directly to the webinar, and it will help you learn this and more. So have a fantastic day, and thanks again for joining us.